The neck is packed with anatomical structures. We divide it into anterior and posterior triangles, separated by the sternocleidomastoid muscle, in order to place these structures into simple categories. So we'll start with the anterior triangle of the neck. Its borders are the midline of the neck, sternocleidomastoid, and the mandible. And it's further divided into four smaller triangles: the carotid, submandibular, submental, and muscular triangles. To really get your head around these, click the link in the video description and you can have a look around this model yourself. So the first we'll discuss is the carotid triangle. Its borders are the posterior belly of the digastric muscle, sternocleidomastoid, finished off by the superior belly of the omohyoid. It contains, as the name suggests, the common, external, and internal carotid arteries, as well as the internal jugular vein and its tributaries. It also contains nerves, namely the sympathetic chain and cranial nerves 9, 10, 11, and 12. If we take a look through here, we can see it contains part of the larynx and pharynx, as well as part of the thyroid gland. Now, the vessels mentioned previously travel in the carotid sheath here, which holds the carotid arteries medially, the internal jugular vein laterally, and the vagus nerve posteriorly. And you can feel your carotid pulse by placing your fingers just medial to the sternocleidomastoid at the level of the superior border of the thyroid cartilage. You'll be placing your fingers on the carotid triangle. The submandibular triangle is next. Its boundaries are the two bellies of the digastric muscle and the mandible. It contains the submandibular gland and surrounding lymph nodes, the hypoglossal and mylohyoid nerves, plus parts of the facial artery and vein. And they extend up onto the mandible from here. The submental triangle is the only unpaired triangle of the neck. Its boundaries are the anterior bellies of the digastric muscles and the hyoid bone. If you've ever seen somebody stroke their goatee, they're pretty much stroking the submental triangle. It contains the submental lymph nodes and part of the anterior jugular vein. The last triangle is the muscular triangle. It's bound by the midline, the omohyoid, and a sternocleidomastoid. Again, that's the midline of the neck, superior belly of omohyoid, and sternocleidomastoid. It contains the sternohyoid and sternothyroid muscles, as well as thyroid and parathyroid glands. And that's it for the anterior triangle. Hit subscribe if you like this video. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.